Hey babes, my name is Jessica and this is my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. I really hope you enjoy. And if you do, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, subscribe down below, and turn on your post notification bell so you can be notified the next time I post a new video. I haven't done my intro in so long. I've been super MIA from my YouTube channel. So go follow me on Instagram because I'm over there every single day almost on my Instagram stories. But let's get into today's video. I wanted to bring it back to the basics. Let's say you're in beauty school or you're a cosmetologist, esthetician, and you want to start offering lash extensions. Well, this video is going to show you every little thing you need to start doing lash extensions. Looking at my hair, it looks a little wonky. I tried doing that like new style where you use, you know, like that big clip and just like drape your hair over it. But my hair is so long, so it kind of just looks like it's in a ponytail. Okay, so I have a list right here on my phone. I'll have it in the description box down below so you guys can just like copy and paste it and little by little start checking off items, start purchasing them. It's not in no particular order, but let's just get right into it. I do have categories that I just made up. So starting off, I'm going to tell you the big items that you definitely need. You don't need to purchase them right now today, but you do need them before you start offering lash extensions. So the first thing is a lash bed. Where are you gonna offer the service? Where's your client gonna lay down? So I personally use a lash recliner. Just a recliner. It's like a sofa. If you are lashing at home, if you're lashing in a studio, it is so aesthetically pleasing. It's so comfy for your guest and for yourself. Let's say you are a traveling lash artist, definitely don't invest in a recliner. You're not going to be able to move it around. So figure out what kind of services, like the lashes, where are you going to offer this service? Are you a traveling lash artist or are you having your guests come to you? So definitely figure out what kind of lash bed is going to be best for you. So a lash recliner, lash bed, a chair, where are you gonna sit? You're not gonna lash standing up. So you definitely need to find a nice comfy little seat where you're gonna sit at, an office chair. There's like lash balls. There's like so many different, I can't even speak anymore, guys. There's so many options out there. There's like, I think like a saddle one. So many out there. Do your research, see which one you want to purchase. Right now is time to research and start saving your coins for these three big ticket items. The next thing is a light. You need a light to be able to see. So you need like a ring light, a glam core. And again, these items are super expensive. They're the big ticket items, the big items that you can't just store in a makeup bag or anything like that. So start researching, start seeing which of these three items would work best for you, for your situation, and start saving for these items because you are going to need them when you're offering these services. Let's talk about storage. All these items from now on are going to be itty bitty. Like everything that we use for lashes are seriously like handheld items. They're really small. So you want a makeup bag or a place where you can contain all these items. It's a lot of items, but you need a place to contain them. So you can go to Ulta, Target, and go into the makeup section. They have like little, you know, square makeup storage, like a little squishy one. I have one right here, something like this. Definitely not this small because this is actually pretty tiny. I think you might be able to get away with something like this, but something a little bit bigger so you could grow into it as well. So having this where you can put all your items in is a must, okay? You don't want them just thrown everywhere collecting dust. You want them nice and organized. The second storage that I highly, highly recommend is somewhere to put your single-use items, which I will be talking about later on in this video, but kind of like your mascara wands, your adhesive rings. If you don't want to purchase like a little bit more of expensive containers, you can just use Ziploc bags, girl. You don't need to invest in nothing crazy, but you definitely want to keep them in a container somewhere where they're not catching dust. so a storage for your single use items. And then tiles. You don't want to use the case where you got your lashes. You don't want to use that to put used lashes back in there. You want to have a tile to have all your lashes nice and organized. They're not going to get squished. You're not putting them in random places on the back of your hand. You want to have a designated area for your lashes. So those three storage items are something that you can invest in now, little by little. Let's talk about aftercare. Personally, I highly recommend you offering aftercare when you are offering lash extensions. You don't want your guests to get some beautiful lashes and then go ruin it with a makeup remover that's not safe for the lashes. You don't want them to go and wash their lashes with shampoo or something like that. So definitely having a good makeup remover and a good lash bath is a must to start off, so your guests can take care of their lashes, and when they come back for their touch-ups, you're not looking at them like, dude, why do you not have any lashes on? Why is there makeup on there? Things like that. So definitely starting off offering lashes, you definitely want to have aftercare as well, in my personal opinion. Single use items is exactly how it sounds. Single use. You're going to use these items once for one guest and then toss it or give it to your guest. So we're going to start off with mascara wands. You want mascara wands to gift to your guest. And so when you're doing your service, if your lashes are looking a little wonky, you can just brush them and see if they are placed correctly. And just to have a mascara wand, we all need them. You want to give them to your guests when you are done with their service so they can brush their lashes at home. The second thing is lip applicators. This is going to help with you prepping the client's lashes. You can actually use a lash bath on them right before their service. I like to use the Cami Nigoon, what is it, the Prep and Prime to prime their lashes. If you are using a primer, bonder, anything like that, however you are trained to do lashes, you're definitely gonna need lip applicators to apply any type of product before the service begins. You also want to have gel pads. All of these items, again, are single use. So having gel pads is a must. As a beginner lash artist, you might be a little heavy-handed, so you don't want to just use tape on the bottom of the lashes. One, it's uncomfortable, and two, if you are a little bit more heavy-handed, the gel pad has cushion, so you're not just poking your client's bottom eye area. When you're removing the gel pads, it's just so easy versus trying to remove tape. When you apply the gel pads, it's just so cooling. So having gel pads to hold down the bottom lashes, and then tape. I put tape in the single use items because you're not going to remove the tape and save it for your next guest. But tape, having tape. I personally love to use Nichibon tape. Having tape in your collection is a must as a lash artist. You're going to use it to, you know, maneuver the eyelid, be able to extend right here, stretch it out, do inner corners, pull back the lashes. Tape is just a must, so definitely find which one you prefer. I love the Nichibon one. It is a little bit expensive in the beginning. It's like $65, $45 on Amazon, but it does last you a long time, and it's a very sensitive, super white, so you can see even the blondest of blondest lashes. It's just a must. I'm also using a green tape right now. I got it from Untamed Artistry, and I kind of like it. I haven't tried it for holding down the bottom, you know, the gel pad, but I have used it like to maneuver the eyelid, and I love it. A couple more items you want to have in the single use item is like napkins, tissues. Napkins, you want to be able to, you know, like wipe down your recliner with Lysol, just clean your studio up a little bit. And then tissue is a must, in my opinion, because you don't want to have your hands on your client's foreheads. Putting a light tissue on there, so in case they have makeup, in case they are breaking out, you don't want to have like your hands on their face, you know. So having tissue is definitely a must. To also put your SMA, to have like your tweezers, your mascara wand, your little adhesive ring, like just have everything nice and laid out ready for your guests, like their gel pads, things like that. having a tissue under that, those items. Once your guest is done, you can throw that tissue away. Super clean, super sanitary. Also, head pads. You want to have a head pad under your guest, like a towel I've seen people use, but then you're going to have to wash them after every guest. I use head pads, like kind of like dental bibs, things like that. So when you are like removing extensions, if like your guest is coming back for a touch up, or if you are doing like a complete lash removal, you have a designated area like right next to them to be able to place your, you know, lash graveyard. You don't want to just have it on your lash bed. You don't want their head just laying on the lash bed as well. It's just a little bit more sanitary as well. Now I'm going to talk to you guys about the liquid category. So adhesive, you want to have adhesive because of course, how are you going to put lashes without adhesive? But this is an item that you want to kind of purchase with your big ticket items. You don't want to purchase an adhesive today and then do lashes in 6 months with that same adhesive. It's not gonna work. You wanna purchase that adhesive as soon as you are gonna start doing lashes so it can be the freshest as possible. And I don't think I added lashes to any of these categories, but now talking about adhesive, I'm like, hello, we need lashes. So lashes is something that you can purchase today. They're not gonna go bad. Just don't open them and have them open like that. You want to keep them closed so there's not dust going all up in your lashes. Going back to the liquid topic, adhesive remover. So if you're applying lashes, you want to make sure you have a remover to take them off. You don't want to offer services where you can't remove the lashes, because unfortunately there's going to be some people that you apply them wrong or that they just don't like the outcome. We're all beginners, so definitely having a lash remover just to be able to remove the lashes is something that you should purchase. I love the Untamed Artistry ones. They come in little packets and they do not go bad, so purchase those. Those are sanitary and they're not like a little jar where their cross-contamination or anything like that. You also need something to prep and prime your client's lashes. I use the Cami Prep and Prime. That's all I use to prep my client's lashes, or I'll go in and do a lash bath. Some people get trained with other people that use bonders, use, I don't know what they use. They actually use like primers. I don't use those items. I just use a prep and prime, but definitely whoever you're getting trained by or however you learn to do lashes, definitely having something like a prep and prime in your kits. And now distilled water. You need distilled water because I also use a mister. I'll talk about that later on, but distilled water just to be able to put it in your mister because you can't put just any regular old water in there. The next category is called tools. And this is personally my favorite category. I feel like you can add your personal touch to these items, get fun colors to match your aesthetics. So the first item on my list is a lash fan. It's not really a lash fan, it's just like a little handheld fan. You can find them on Amazon. A lot of lash brands carry it. My personal favorite is the bladeless fan. You need a fan because you are not gonna wanna you are not gonna want to lash on wet lashes. So when you're prepping your guest, you wanna make sure you are fanning out the lashes so they can be completely dry. The adhesive we use is a cyanoacrylate that cures with H2O, AKA water in the air. So if you just instantly start lashing on wet lashes, those lashes are gonna pop off right away. They might crystallize instantly, which gives that adhesive, it turns the adhesive white. So you wanna make sure you are fanning the lash, brushing it out, and getting it nice and ready for you to be able to lash. The second thing is a mister. I kind of already talked about the mister with the distilled water, but again, the mister is a must in my opinion. How many times am I gonna say a must in my opinion? Take a shot every time I say that. Just kidding, don't. A mister, because again, talking about the cyanoacrylate, the fumes, I sometimes use the mister throughout the service and definitely before my guest opens their eyes. So when you are lashing, the fumes are sometimes lingering. If your guest wears eye contacts, is sometimes the adhesive is absorbing that moisture from your guest's eyes to cure. So just having a mister to be able to, you know, help cure the adhesive, help illuminate the fumes is a must in my opinion. The third thing is an the next thing is an adhesive shaker. I feel like it's a must. Oh my goodness. Having an adhesive shaker is definitely going to help, you know, merge those two items together versus you shaking it with your hand. Cami, she explained it kind of like a salad dressing where like the items go on the bottom and then the oil on the top. You want to make sure you're shaking it so everything, you know, is nice and shooken up. So having an adhesive shaker in your collection is a must, in my opinion. Yeah, having an adhesive shaker, they're very inexpensive. All these items, of course, apart from like the bed, the light, and your chair can fit nicely in a cosmetic bag, and you can start purchasing those items now. They're not going to go to waste. Those are items that are just going to stay in your kit nice and ready for whenever you're ready to lash. The next thing is a Sharpie. I don't know if I mentioned it earlier, but when you are lashing, you want to have, you know, gel pads, the tape, and you want to be able to map out your client's lash sets. Even if you are not super going into super detail about your mapping, you still want to map so you don't have crazy layer lashes going everywhere. You want them to be pretty symmetrical when your guest opens their eyes. And to help with that as well is a little dental mirror. So many lash brands carry these mirrors. It's personally a must as a beginner, and it's going to, you're just going to keep that mirror until you are a seasoned lash artist. Being able to see if your guest eyes are open, how the sets are turning out, if they're, you know, laying the proper way. You need a little dental mirror to be able to see that. And with the mirror that I'm talking about, a handheld mirror. So when you're done with the service, if you don't have like a mirror in the studio, it's so easy for you to just give your guest the mirror, them see and say, oh my goodness, yes, they look good, or oh, can we switch up, add a little bit here, add a little bit there. Having a little handheld mirror for them to be able to see what you did. Hello, tweezers. I was not gonna forget about those. So how are you gonna apply lashes? You need tweezers. You need at least two. Some good isolating tweezers and a good placing tweezers. You just want to have some good tweezers that have a very good grip, because if you accidentally place a lash wrong and you need to remove it and you don't have a good grip tweezers, just don't even offer this service if you don't have good grip lash tweezers, because it's going to hurt your client's lashes. You might pull those lashes off their natural lashes. You need to have some good gripping tweezers for when they come back and they're doing, you're doing a touch up and some of them are outgrown. You want to be able to grip their natural lash, grip the extension and just lightly pop it off without that hair just like sliding throughout the tweezer. If you've been doing lashes, if you know, you know, and if you don't, please get some good tweezers. Test it out on your hair. Grab them on both sides. Like grab one piece of hair, grab the tweezer on this side, grab it on here and pull it. If it breaks that hair, your tweezers are good. But if one tweezer, the hair is like falling off, try to find another tweezer, because that's not good gripping tweezers. Last but not least, scissors. You can use scissors for multiple things like opening packages, but what I personally use my scissors on an everyday basis for is tape. So when I am pulling back the layers like this or anything maneuvering the eyelid, I don't use that big tape. I cut it in half and then I have two sections. So I'm able to, you know, put it right here, and just having a tape to be able to cut gel pads if your guest has a different eye shape and they're just not laying properly, having some scissors is going to save your lashing day sometimes. Last but not least, cleaning supplies. So in this category, I have Clorox wipes, Lysol spray, Barbicide, hand sanitizer. For the obvious, you want to have Lysol so you can spray down your bed, wipe it down after each guest. Clorox wipes so you can clean your glam core, items that you don't want to just spray, like your scissors, your lash mirror, Barbicide to sanitize and disinfect your lash tweezers, and hand sanitizer, of course. Obviously, you don't want to start your service without washing your hands and then sanitizing them as well. So with that being said, this is like my beginner guide to all the items you need before you start lashing. And I think there might be a couple more, but this is kind of what you need. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you guys did and you found it helpful, don't forget to share this video with a lash friend. Let's share the lash love. If you enjoyed, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down so I can know. Subscribe down below and turn on your post notification bell so you can be notified the next time I post a new video. And if you guys have any specific videos you guys want me to make, definitely leave it in the comments down below. I'll be sure to make those for you. And until then, bye my loves. You can also subscribe to my channel. If you click my face that just popped up, you're subscribed to my channel. And if you want, you can go watch two other of my videos before you head out. I love you. Bye.